The first one, and for me the most important one always out of any of the pedals, is the tuner, because I'd be lost without it. So the Boss tuner I've used since I can remember, which was actually late in the game, I should say, considering I started playing like about 12. It wasn't until about I was 18 or 19 that Paul and Tony from At the Drive-In, they sat me down and they said, "We love you. We love your playing style. You know, everything's great, but we just want to introduce you to something that we think will really help you out." And they bought me my first tuner.
Wow. Okay.
And it was a Boss tuner. So yeah, now I just have to have it because I'm an imbecile. And then the newest one would be the Slicer, which I picked up last year right before we started doing the band. And I got that at Noise Bug in Pomona in California. They always have a lot of great pedals, and sort of goes further into like the things that I was trying to do with the tremolo pedals, you know.
Sure.
But it has these cool harmonic things that happen in it that just don't happen, you know, with tremolos. And
right.
Again, it's real versatile, especially the fact that you can tap tempo the whole damn thing, you know.
Yeah.
So you can just sort of be changing it up all the time. So it's pretty cool. And then for me the another cornerstone is the digital delay, the DD5. Had that since I can remember, since it came out. Me and my friend Jeremy, who played in Mars Volta, we both saved up and we went, you know, half on it, and you know, and we ordered it, and I remember we got it, and we were using it on everything, on all our four track recordings. You know, we were like, okay, great, put it on the guitar, put it on the voice, now put it on the drums, now put it on those samples, right. You know. The most common setting for me is the effect all the way up, if you can imagine that.
Okay.
The effect all the way up, the third, number three, the three setting, and then I have the feedback at about, what is that, about 2 o'clock, and the delay time at about, I guess that would be about 10 o'clock, and it's pretty much just the standard it works for. Oh, sorry. Pretty standard. I could use that for almost everything, you know, so I really love that, just for stabs or just, you know, stuff like that, or just playing notes with. I started writing with the delay pedal a lot, just because, for the simple reason that it was like, oh, it sounds like way more notes than I'm actually playing.
Right,
I sound
right.
Pretty good right now,
okay,
you know.
Okay.
So yeah, and so then later the thing was to learn from the actual pedal and to actually try and play that many notes. You know, not for the sake of like virtuosity or anything like that, but just because it was a challenge. It's like, oh, I wonder, now that I'm used to that sound, I wonder if I could recreate it without the pedal.
Right.
And so that's what actually got me into like trying to play a lot of notes, was just sort of chasing around the DD5, you know. I mean, sometimes I'll hit it just for one note,
right.
You know, so because I think of the live setting very much, especially with these guys, as being in the studio. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's very much about, you know, we're constantly mixing ourselves on stage. So whether it's just a volume thing or just a depth thing, putting on the delay to sort of wash it out, step back a little bit so that the synth can breathe through, or, you know, anything like that. Same thing with, like, you know, hitting reverbs. The same way that you would use it in a mix to make sure that everything is occupying the right space. With stuff like the delay, or the slicer is real fun for that stuff too, because, you know, you could just play simple. Just this. I mean, just that's super fun, you know, but then you can get into. And then let it, you know, and then variations on that, you know. So you're doing sort of a slicer thing with your hand, and the slicer's doing its own thing, and then if you hold it out, then it really gets to do its, or just simple, you know. I usually tend to like the effect level a little louder, so. And then you, of course, you can.
Thank you.
delay pedal. You know, so at times you can really make it sound like a whole different instrument, you know. For me nowadays, it's just like I have a certain, just this little space to occupy, pretty much one of each type of sound, and then I use that everywhere. If I go in the studio, you know, I try to find ways to use it with the, you know, with what I have. Actually, but the best advice I can give is don't listen to anybody. That's a bit, because somebody will tell you it's one way. Like, that's what works for me right now. Yeah. But somebody else listening, they shouldn't pay attention to me. They should do whatever feels right for them, you know. And so if it feels right to use a lot of pedals, because I did that for a long time, like, yeah, again, to cover up my lack of ability, you know what I mean? It's just like I just, you know, played with a lot of different pedals. I saw them all as instruments. So it's like, you know, it was a way of adding. So then I had to have more, and now I just like keeping it simple.